Assalamualaikum students, today is Monday 20th July 2020 and before starting today's lesson, let's review that what was the homework given to you on Friday. Alright, so on Friday I gave you to practice DEF part on workbook page number 20 and what you have to do here, you were asked to form questions and आपको पता है दैट मैंने आपको इसमें एक गाइडलाइन भी दी थी. वी हैव हाईलाइटेड, यू सी हियर द बिगिनिंग क्वेश्चन वर्ड्स. ये मैंने आपको हाईलाइट भी बताया था, करवाया था कि आपका जो बिगिनिंग वर्ड है वो क्या होगा, वाई, व्हाट, हु. एंड एज यू नो दैट वी आर फॉर्मिंग क्वेश्चंस, सो ये जंबल्ड थे, हमने क्वेश्चन को अरेंज करके राइट किया. सो एट द एंड यहाँ पे पंक्चुएशन कौन सा आना था, क्वेश्चन मार्क, राइट. सो लेट्स सी if you have done that correctly. D, why has he not come to work for 3 days? E, what present did she give the child on his birthday? F, who is the owner of that tall building? All right, so I'm sure all of you have done that correctly. आप सबने ये correctly attempt किया होगा. Now let's begin today's lesson. Today we are going to learn about countable and uncountable nouns. That what is a countable noun and what are uncountable nouns. For that, first of all, let me explain that. What do you understand by the word countable? Countable means something that you can count. All right, and uncountable, that is something that is not countable. You cannot count that. For example, let me show you some examples. You see, what is this? Yes, this is sugar. So can you count the sugar? क्या आप ये sugar count कर सकते हैं? No. So it means that sugar is uncountable noun. What is a noun? Let's revise. Yes, very good, excellent. Noun is a naming word. Noun is the name of a place, person, thing or animal. And sugar is a noun because it's a name of a thing. ये एक चीज़ का name है. So can you count the sugar? No, you cannot count the sugar. So it means that sugar is uncountable noun, right? And what do you see here? What is it? Absolutely, these are coins, you see? Can you count the coins? Obviously you can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are 9 coins on my palm. I've got 9 coins on my hand. So it means that coins are countable now. So coins are countable now. Next, let me show you these marbles. Alright? These are the marbles. Can you count the marbles? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, these are 5 marbles. And these are the ping pong balls. Can you count these balls? Yes, these are 3 balls. So it means that balls are also countable noun. You see, these 3 balls are also countable noun. So ball is also countable. Again, let me show you another example. For example, let's take this toy. Hairs. This toy has got hairs. So can you count the hairs of this toy? Hair is a noun. Can you count the noun hair? No. Hairs are also uncountable. So these are the examples. These are a few examples of countable and uncountable nouns. Let me show you these color pencils. Can you count these color pencils? You know, pencil is a noun. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. These are 11 coloring pencils. So it means pencils are countable nouns. So this is all about countable and uncountable nouns. So wo sab cheeze jinhe aap count kar sakte hain, those are called countable nouns. Aur wo sab cheeze, wo sab nouns, wo sab things jinko aap count nahi kar sakte, those are called uncountable nouns. I'm sure aapne ye understand kiya hoga. So now I would like you to take out your workbooks. Let's begin with our exercise. Alright, this is workbook page number 20 and 21. Alright, so page number 20 we have the definition of countable and uncountable noun. So let's read this first. When a noun can be counted, we call it countable noun. As I've shown you in examples, ki wo noun jisko hum count kar sakte hain. For example, as I showed you the coins, these are countable, so it means coins are countable now. All right, for example pencils, हम pencils को count कर सकते हैं, so it means pencil जो है वो countable noun है. Again, for example markers, again हम इसे count कर सकते हैं, these are countable nouns. And as I showed you these marbles, these are countables, इनको count किया जा सकता है. Balls, ये भी count की जा सकती हैं. All right, so these are the countable nouns. The nouns we can count, those are called countable nouns. And the nouns which are not countable, those are called uncountable nouns. Un means जिनको count नहीं किया जा सकता. So here we have got some of the examples like eggs. आप eggs count कर सकते हैं? Can you count the eggs? Absolutely. So it means egg is the countable noun. Marbles, pots, heads, clouds. All right, that's countable noun. And what are the uncountable nouns? Uncountable nouns are which cannot be counted. For example, water, tea, sugar, stars, money, sand. These are the uncountable nouns. All right, so इसकी बहुत सारी examples हो सकते हैं, but here we are highlighting few of them. All right, children. So these are the examples. Now let's fill up the exercise given on workbook page number 21. I would like you to write down the day, Monday, 20th July 2020, at the top left corner, and then let's read the statement. Try to think of 5 countable and 5 uncountable nouns. Write them here. You are asked to write 5 examples of countable nouns and 5 examples of uncountable nouns. Again, I'm repeating this. Always remember, countable means wo noun jinko aap count kar sakte hain. Finger, for example, finger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've got 5 fingers. So it means that finger is a countable noun. Finger is a noun, na? Finger ek cheez ka name hai. This is a part of your body. So it means finger. Fingers are countable nouns. And uncountable, jisko hum count nahi kar sakte. For example, your hairs, stars, wool, sugar. So you can write any of the example. Aap yahan pe koi si bhi suitable example write kar sakte hain. Trees, baskets, cows, fingers, pens, these are countable nouns. Uncountable nouns like wool, sugar, money, ink, water, stars, tea, milk, right? These are uncountable nouns. So that's how you will fill up by writing down, fill up the blanks by writing down the examples of countable and uncountable nouns. Next we have use so many or so much to fill up the blanks. Now, the use of so many and so much, how do we use that? Let's find out. And there are a few picture clues on the next page, that is page number 22. And those picture clues will help us to fill up these blanks. Let's take a look at these pictures. For example, picture A, you see the money. Picture B, this is the closet. You see the clothes are, you know, it is filled up with the clothes, this wardrobe. Then C, pots. D, we have book. What do we see on picture E? Yes, clouds. F, we see the picture of paint. So these are the pictures, and these pictures are the clues which are gonna help us to fill up these blanks. But before filling up this, let's take a look how we're gonna use so much and so many. As you learnt about countable and uncountable nouns, right? So with countable noun, we use this phrase, so many, right? All the nouns which are countable, we use the phrase so many with them. And those nouns which are uncountable, which cannot be counted, we use the phrase so much, for example, so much with them. For example, let's take sugar. Sugar is a noun which cannot be counted. Sugar is the example of uncountable noun. So it means that we will use the phrase so much with that, right? And trees are the countable noun, and we will use the phrase so many with that. All right, so let's practice this by filling up this exercise. Let's complete it. All right, so use so many and so much to fill up the blanks. The picture clues on the next page will help. On picture A, what do we have on picture A? All right, this is the money. So let's read the statement. Akbar has dash that he can buy what he likes. Akbar has so much money that he can buy what he likes. Alright, हमें कैसे पता चला that we are gonna use so much? Because ये picture किस noun की है? Money की. Alright, money की picture है ये, so it means that money is uncountable noun. And what phrase we use with uncountable noun? So much. Alright, let me write down here money, clothes, books, pots, clouds, tea, clouds and paint. You see the words I have written here? These are the clue words. Ab ye sab noun hai. Money is a noun, clothes, books, paint, clouds, tea and pots. These are all nouns. On B we have, there are dash in the cupboard. What do you see in the cupboard? Alright, clothes. Clothes are countable. So what goes here? So many. Alright, there are so many clothes in the cupboard that won't shut. Shut means close. C we have, there was dash in the pot, teapot, that we all had 2 cups. There was so much tea in the teapot. Tea is uncountable noun, so that's why we use so much. Let me highlight this for you. So much, so many, and so much. You see, money, clothes, tea. These are noun. Money is uncountable, clothes are countable, tea is also uncountable. Alright, so that's how you will fill these up. D, E, F are, you know, to be practiced as homework. You have to fill up these blanks as homework. Let me help you with the words, with the nouns. D, E, F. What do you see on picture D? Yes, books. And what do you think that? Books are countable noun or is it uncountable? Absolutely, books are countable nouns. And clouds, these are countables. Paint, and that is also uncountable. You cannot count the paint. So much will be used with the paint. Books, many, right? And clouds, many. So that's how you will complete your homework, right? So it's time to look at the diary. Today's diary is do workbook page number 21, C2, DEF as homework, and learn countable and uncountable noun. This is the workbook page number 21, you see, and this is the C2, alright, C2, DEF part to be completed as homework. Ye 3 aapne as homework complete karne, alright. So thank you very much for watching the video. Look after yourself, stay home, stay safe.